Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So today in this video I am going to introduce about that seven zones of the oceans. That ocean is divided into many zones. So in this video I am going to discuss about the different zones, like some of them are like internal zone, territorial zone, contiguous zone, and EEZ, that is exclusive economy zone, and another one is that high sea. So as we know that there is one unclosed United Nations Convention Law of the Sea. According to that, that sea is divided into many parts, different parts, that each parts have their own boundary lines. So as we know that zones are divided into five main parts, that five zone names are internal water, territorial water, contiguous zones, and exclusive economic zones. And another one that is the farthest from the baseline, that is high sea. So all this zone I will discuss one by one. So let's start this video with the internal zone. That internal zone is that very near to our land, that like our some ports, some seaports, and some offshore installation, that all are comes under the internal waters. Like some all government operations and like all the work undertaken by the governments that is near our coastline, that is called internal waters. Another one, that is territorial sea line. As defined by United Nations Convention Law of the Sea, that is UNCLOS, territorial zone is the belt of coastal water extending at 12 nautical miles, that is 22 kilometers from the nearest baseline. So this all area comes under the territorial zones. Now contiguous zone is a band of water extended farthest from the outer edge of the territorial sea up to 24 nautical miles, that is 44.4 kilometers from the baseline, within which a state can exert limited control for the purpose of preventing and punish violation of its custom, fiscal, immigration and sanitary laws. Now let's talk about the most important zone, that is exclusive economic zone. As per UNCLOS, United Nations Convention Law of the Sea, EEZ is an area of the sea in which a state has special rights regarding the exploration and use of marine resources, that is including the energy production from the water and the wind, and it is extended up to 200 nautical miles from the baseline. That from in that area that government can use their resources like mining and the energy production from the oil, from water, and they can explore, take out the water, whatever they want in that area, they have, that state have the rights to do in that exclusive economic zone area, that is to 200 nautical mile from the baseline, that comes under the state and governments. Now I am going to show the maps of India, how the zones are divided from the coastline of the Indian water. So let's start with the, there are territorial zones, contiguous zone, and exclusive zone. So let's start, this is like our boundary of India. From there 12 nautical mile from the our coastline, that is territorial sea. After that, from 12 nautical mile, the from baseline, this is suppose baseline, after that baseline the 24 nautical mile from the coastline of the India, that this area also are contiguous zone, that is 24 nautical mile from the coast of the India to the out farthest from the sea, 24 nautical mile, this area you can see this all are comes under the contiguous zone area. This area, this dotted that one, you can see that I written 24, that is contiguous zone area. After that contiguous zone area, that this area you can see, this is EEZ. This all area, that area is like 200 nautical mile from the baseline. This area, that is 200 nautical mile from the coastal line of the India. This area are comes under the exclusive economy zone. In this area, that government have the power and the rights that whatever he want to do, it's under the state control. This all area are EEZ area. If we talk about India's EEZ, that is exclusive economic zone, it has 18th largest EEZ in the world. So normally it covers 200 nautical mile from the baseline, but Indian government has asked from UNCLOS, United Nations Convention Law of the Sea, that extend our EEZ to more than 300 nautical mile from our baseline.
दैट इज बिकॉज इट कवर्स ए वाइड रेंज ऑफ द ओशियन, बिकॉज नॉर्मली ईजेड ऑफ इंडिया कवर्स, इट इंक्लूड्स द लक्षद्वीप सी एंड द साउथ वेस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ इंडिया एंड अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड एंड द बे ऑफ बंगाल. सो द वाइड ओशियंस कवर्स द इंडियाज ईजेड. सो इट आस्क आवर फ्रॉम वन क्लॉज टू प्लीज एक्सटेंड फ्रॉम 200 to 300 नॉटिकल माइल फ्रॉम आवर बेस लाइन. So these are all of India's EEZ exclusive economic zone. So now an EEZ exclusive economic zone provides a nation with greater access to oil, natural gas, minerals and other marine resources. Freedom of navigation, international trade, national security. India has exclusive control over the resources in the exclusive economic zone area, including the navigation of seafaring trade and the warships and the vessels in the area of trading, like cargo ships, and all these are under the control of India, Indian governments. So these are of Indian EEZ area, is Indian exclusive economic zone area. Whatever the action done here is under the action of our states, that is Indian state. So that Indian state know about, aware about what the situation going about that EEZ. Recently some of the news came that 7 fleet conduct freedom of navigation in the operation of EEZ area of Indian, and some other country may come in the EEZ area without the permission. So government should aware about that. Now let's talk about the farthest zone, that is the fifth zone of the sea, that is high sea. It is an area beyond the nautical national jurisdiction, that is, it is not under the control of any state. The high seas are those marine area that is outside 200 nautical miles, that is 200 nautical miles from the EEZ area of each coastal nation. International water, that high sea we also called that it is international water. During this area, ships sailing in high sea are generally under the jurisdiction of the flag state. However, when a ship is involved in certain criminal act such as piracy and any violation of that navigation, any nation can exercise jurisdiction under the doctrine of universal jurisdiction, that international law. They can impose on and raise an issue about that vessel, that these are not following the proper regulation. So these are all under the about the high seas area. So this all about the 7 zones, 5 zones we discussed, all about the universal zones.